Hey everybody, welcome back to another outcoming movies.
What?
Welcome back.
We're rolling?
Yeah.
Wait, start over.
I'm not gonna start over.
All right, fair enough. I'll keep going.
Okay.
I'll roll with the punches.
Three movies coming out this week, and one movie review.
Alrighty.
Yeah.
What's coming out this week?
The Boss.
Mm.
The Invitation.
Mm.
Louder Than Bomb.
Bombs. There's an S, the plural. It's multiple bombs.
Let's start with The Boss first.
Because I'm bossy.
The Melissa McCarthy, she plays...
So we're done right now, right? You say Melissa McCarthy, we can just turn it off, right?
No.
Yeah, we're good. Just move on to the next one.
She plays the boss, and she gets bankrupt. Yeah. So she has to live with her ex...
Assistant co-worker. Well, a co-worker. She's a boss. It was like her underling. It was like her assistant.
Yeah, one of her assistants. And she has to live with him because she's broke after 6 months being in jail.
She got a trophy. Popped like insider trade. Kind of same thing that, what's that one woman? Martha Stewart. I think you're kind of going for like a Martha Stewart type thing where she got popped.
So she gets caught doing a trade and she basically had to get like a lawyer, which she can't afford a lawyer because she's bankrupt. Mm-hmm. And the rest of the movie, she's trying to get back up. And she's
rebuild her empire.
Rebuild, and she's helping Girl Scout girls.
Yeah, that's where she's starting off, Girl Scouts. Yeah. So you're trying to rebuild your multi-trillion dollar fucking company, you still Girl Scout cookies.
Yeah.
That is it.
I look forward to it. I like her movies, Melissa McCarthy.
I know you do. I know you are a fan.
Yeah, we watched The Spy and then
Tammy.
The Heat. Yeah, except for Identity Theft. And next is...
Well, I didn't get my thoughts on it. It sucks. Oh my God, I'm sick of her. Like, she's not... It's like... I don't know how to explain it. It's like her movies are just so one note. And I feel like she's good in small doses. Give me a movie and she has... Like, Hangover 3 was perfect. Because she shows up for her one scene, came back at the end, movie
Hangover
over.
3?
Yeah, she was the... She worked in the pawn shop. She ends up marrying Zach Galifianakis at the end. Spoiler alert.
I thought that was her.
Oh, yeah, that was her. And the thing is, it's perfect. It worked. I did not see Bridesmaids, so I don't know how much Melissa McCarthy we got in that movie. But she was a supporting role. It's when they thrust her out in the front that you're just like, ugh. I will say, it's weird when I watch her movies. They always start off horrible. And then I always end up giving them like a this number. Like, she's a decent actress, but it's just like, I don't like the shit she does. Because there's always like that one scene where she gets serious. And I love those scenes. Identity Theft, she has the... Anyways, she has a dinner with Jason Bateman, and then she has a kind of an emotional scene, and you're like, wow, you know, she can act. That's odd. The Heat, kind of same thing. Like, there's this like, moment where, you know, they have to, like, bond and go for the bad guys or whatever. This is another good scene. But it's just like, I don't know. After watching them, it's almost like eating KFC. I'm going to steal a buddy of mine's analogy here. He did an analogy for another movie. I'm going to steal it. It's like KFC, you know. I'll eat it once. It ain't bad, I guess. But then you go to the toilet afterwards, and you don't really want KFC again after that. Same thing. Melissa McCarthy... You watch it, you're like, it wasn't as bad, I guess. Then the next movie comes out, you're like, I don't want to fucking watch that. Don't make me watch that. And then she makes me watch that. And I'm like, oh, God.
You make me watch stuff, too.
So. I make her watch good stuff. She watches fucking gold when she's with me.
No, you watch gold when you're with me.
I watch garbage.
No.
Like The Boss.
No.
I'm sure I'm going to fucking watch that.
Next, Louder Than Bombs.
Louder Than Bombs.
It's about this family. They're... like, kind of rough time since their mother and wife passed, got in a wreck.
Mm-hmm.
And they believe, like, what's the real truth? Did she really get in a car wreck, or was it a suicide or something like that? It's like a mystery.
Well, they don't tell you that. You're kind of piecing together when you watch the trailer, so you don't know exactly what. We're speculating, because like, as the whole thing, the whole time there's like, does the younger son know? Does he know the truth? What's the truth? And the whole time, it's like they ain't, I mean, that's what a trailer does, I guess. You know, you're supposed to be like, oh, yeah. Lord. But it looks like she does, like, jerk the wheel in front of the car or the semi. So, I don't know. And it looks like she probably was suicidal before. I don't know. It's horrible.
It's a mystery. So, yeah.
Jesse Eisenberg being Jesse Eisenberg, which has got to be better than his Lex Luthor. His Lex Luthor wasn't bad. I don't want to jump on that bandwagon. It wasn't great, but it wasn't bad either. I'm just not huge on Jesse Eisenberg. Like, it's weird. He'll win me over, and then he'll turn around and do something stupid. And it just looks boring to me. So, I mean, it's a mark against him. Like, I love him in Zombieland. Now You See Me. And The Double. That's it. That's all I give Jesse Eisenberg. I didn't see Social Network. I'm sorry. I'm sure it's awesome. It won an award, so there you go. That's all I got.
Okay. So, Nexus Invitation.
Invitation.
Invitation is about the ex-wife and her husband invites them to a party.
By two.
Him and his wife.
Wait, so, okay, yeah, the ex-wife.
It's
the husband. Okay, you're okay. The main character is the guy.
Yeah.
His ex-wife and her new husband invites him and his girlfriend
to
a party.
And there's like a bunch of other friends and new people that gathered around. And like they think something's fishy.
No, he thinks.
Yeah, he
no
thinks.
No one else thinks. Everybody
he
else
thinks
like,
something's fishy. Why would he invite like these people over for a party and which they haven't talked in like 2 years? So, I guess they're trying to turn a new leaf and such. And there's like, I guess there's getting killed off one by one.
Well, you don't know that. That's the thing. Like, this trailer.
It seems like it. Cause they're like screaming and
stuff.
Well,
you get reaction shots, but that's the thing. You don't know what they're reacting to. Because that's the thing. This trailer. You can go one of two ways. Either, yes, the.
You think there's
the
like a.
Ex-wife, you know, her new husband, the friend.
Yeah.
You know, maybe they're plotting something. But then it's also like maybe the main guy's crazy and maybe he's self-destructive and he's, you just don't know. Now, I would almost think probably, yeah, they're up to something because, you know, it's a movie from, but you don't know. And that's the thing, this trailer doesn't show you much. And I will say I like that because now, I mean, I really am curious, like, what the fuck? Because, I mean, you don't see nothing. The trailer, I mean, I urge you guys to check the trailer out. You don't see shit. Like, it literally is
you
just like.
You think that there's be killing around, but you don't know.
Yeah, I mean, I'm assuming someone's getting killed at some point, but you just don't know what's causing it. You don't see anybody actually doing anything. You just see people
screaming
and freaking out, so.
Yeah. I get a thumbs up.
I want to see it. It looks good.
Yeah. And I'm
going
to review Dead 7.
Why would you review this?
Because it's a good movie.
Oh, my God. All right, go ahead. Kick us off.
Dead 7 is about seven of the boy bands. Seven, yeah.
What?
Seven boy bands, right?
Four. Backstreet Boys, NSYNC, O-Town, 90 Degrees.
Altogether, it's like seven people, though.
Well, yeah, but they're not all boy bands, but there's two girls.
Ah, yeah, like boy bands and some girls. And it's a Western, and this woman... like mixed copperheads, which are zombies.
Yeah, just another name for zombies.
Zombies, and these zombies are attacking these everybody. Yeah, attacking everybody. And Nick Carter and them are trying to like kill them all.
The mayor decides to form a group to stop the zombie attacks.
Yeah.
And so they get together, you know, they don't necessarily go out to get these seven, but they get, you know, these certain people together, and then they just have to form seven. And then their mission is to go up the mountains, find Apocalypto, which is the girl's lair, and kill her. And then, of course, that's the movie right there. That's your plot.
Yeah, that's it.
Well,
I enjoy it. I like the explodiness and the sword, samurai sword.
Yeah. It is bad. It was bad.
I thought it was pretty good.
the acting was
the
just...
The blooding effect I thought was pretty good.
Are you for real?
That you can, like, shoot on, like, freaking the whole freaking
and the head
explodes.
Just turned to a cartoon bubble. It popped. That's what it was. It just turned into a cartoon balloon pop.
I don't think so.
But I was not a big fan of this movie. It wasn't the worst. Now, I don't want to go off like this is the worst thing I've ever seen in my life. No, it wasn't. But it was just very, it lost my attention pretty early on. Like, it was just like, it took itself way too serious. Because the gimmick, like she said earlier, the gimmick of this movie was they casted all these former boy band members together. You got 3 from Backstreet Boys, 2 from NSYNC, like most of O-Town, and like 1 guy from 98 Degrees. And not like the people you know either. Like, there was no Justin Timberlake. No. Alright, no, that would have saved
Bass.
It. That would have saved it. Justin Timberlake could have saved the entire fucking movie, but he...
Lance Bass. That's all I remember his name.
Yeah, but I mean, he's not really that good of an actor. I'm talking about, you know, Timberlake's a hell of an actor. Like, that guy can fucking act. Nobody else really can. And it shows. Like I said, the highlights, if I'm not just going to show this movie, if I had to give you highlights, AJ plays a villain.
Yeah.
He's Johnny Trombone or Johnny something. It's something. It don't matter. But he plays a sadistic clown, a mime. But thing is, while he's the only one that really does a really good performance, it's like he's doing a Joker impersonation. Like,
laughing?
Yeah, just constantly laughing and just, you know, like he's doing like a Heath Ledger with more of the Cesar Romero laugh is what he's trying to do. And it wasn't bad, but it didn't really fit the movie. So, I don't know. But I will say that's a high point. Joey Fatone was okay. He kind of did a Randy Quaid impersonation, just like crazy drunk. But, I don't know. Really, the acting, rest of them was just horrible. Like, it was just really bad. And I was really kind of, I wasn't really surprised. I don't know. I wasn't surprised that Nick Carter couldn't act, because I'm sure if you put him in anything else, he'd suck. But I'm like, he wrote this. Like, he co-wrote this fucking screenplay. Like, he should know how, like, the, you know, I don't know. Like, Quentin Tarantino, you know, people complain that he's not a great actor, whatever. But it's like, no, he's playing that character. He knows it. Like, I believe that that character is, you know, whoever he is. I'm sorry. I was just like, no, Nick, you're fucking Nick Carter, and you are barely pretending to be a cowboy here. There's, like, certain scenes that are supposed to be kind of emotional. You know, certain people get, you know, picked off, and you're just like, you're not buying it. You ain't buying it at all. A lot of the love stories felt forced. Like I said, the directing was really horrible.
And I think, was the guy with the bum?
He was the guy from O-Town. I don't know.
Yeah, his
Komodo was his name.
His girlfriend, I didn't like her. She looked like all, like, girly, like she didn't.
Well, she was. She was a prostitute. She wasn't even part of the Seven, Dead Seven. She was just like, she tagged along.
Yeah.
So yeah, I don't know. Like I said, overall, and maybe I'm judging it too harshly. I mean, for fuck's sake, it is an asylum movie that is made for Sci-Fi Channel. So, you know, going into it, you knew it was going to be garbage.
You knew it was going to be great.
Yeah.
Super great.
But see, she's a big Backstreet Boy fan, so, I mean, you like NSYNC too, but you really, when she found out that fucking Nick Carter, because she gets all moist for Nick Carter, she knew he was making a movie, so there was no stopping her from watching this thing. Like, I tried. I was like, oh, I didn't try to stop her. I tried to stop myself. I was like, I don't want to watch it. She's like, no, watch it with me. It's a horror movie. It's brand new. You'll like it. It'll be good. It wasn't.
It was awesome.
But yeah, I guess Deborah Wilson did all right, but it was just kind of a weird role. She reminded me of, one of the pirate movies, I don't remember which one, but you had a girl in her name was a Calypso?
I don't know.
It was one of them.
One of the movies.
It was either 2 or 3, but she was like this, like kind of, she's like a voodoo Haitian woman. Deborah Wilson kind of reminded me of her, actually. But actually, it's just kind of an odd role altogether. But once again, I mean, the movie itself, which, I mean, it was destined to be garbage. So
no, it was destined to be awesome.
Was it? So, in my opinion, I would say, I mean, it's not even in that whole, like, it's so bad, it's good realm. It's just, it's a bad movie. It just is.
It's a good movie, so you should just totally check it out.
I guess if you're a big fan, I'm talking super fan of, like, the boy bands, sure. If you're undiscriminating against bad zombie movies, go for it. If you like to see a post-apocalyptic, you know, Western, it crosses, like, you know, they're you know, it's a cross because they have, like, you know, motorcycles and cars, and there's also people on horseback and shit. So, I mean it does try to, like, you know, crossbreed this shit together, but unsuccessfully. Yeah.
So thumbs up. So check it out. And if you see any of these movies, let me know how.
Oh, you mean the one coming out this weekend?
Yeah. Let me know how it is.
If you guys see Dead 7, it's on Sci-Fi Channel. We got on demand. So, we know, it opened up last Friday. But we watched it last night. And so, I mean, if you guys get a chance to watch Dead 7, let us know what you think. Let us know which one's right.
Yeah.
I don't care if her opinions are like, no. It's a statement. These are facts. I said sucks. She says great. So, you tell us which one what you agree with. So,
thumbs up if you seen Dead 7 and like it. So it giving you a thumbs up.
Yeah.
And so that's it. Till tomorrow on Mind's Parallel Reviews.
Give us a little preview. What are you reviewing tomorrow?
Green Hornet.
Yeah.
And Bill. Bob? No, Bill.
Oh my god.
Bill and Ted.
Yeah.
Bogus Journey.
Bill and Ted's Bogus Journey.
Yeah.
I probably won't be here for that one. Mm-hmm. I'll skip it, so.
Yeah. So.
Good double feature. Yeah. Not bad double feature.
Till tomorrow.
And I'll just see you guys whenever.